Good morning children, I hope class 6th children are watching this video and I hope you must be keeping well. If you remember, we have started factors and multiples and many things already we have seen like divisibility test for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 and 11 and some other things also we have seen, and it was told to complete exercise 2B. I hope most of you might have completed. But then also I thought that few questions you might be having, in few questions you might be having some problem, and that's why today very quickly we will see few questions from exercise 2B, and this will be the last video for factors and multiples for exercise 2B, and next day we will start next topic. So let's see quickly a few questions. I hope all the revision task you might have done, you must have done. So it will be better if you keep, if you have solved this exercise, you keep notebook also together, and if any confusion is there or some mistakes you have done, that can be corrected also. Few questions from every main questions we will take. So let's start. Here you have exercise 2B. Test the divisibility of the following numbers by 2. If you remember last day, for the divisibility of 2, what I had told you, it was told that if one's digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, then that number will be divisible by 2. So here you see, you check that, suppose you have first number is 2650. First number you have 2650 and your ones digit is 0, so definitely this will be divisible by 2. Next number you see, next number you have 69435. Now you see, your ones digit is 5 and this does not come under this 02468, so this is not even number. And that's why this number will not be divisible by 2. So how will you write your answer? Suppose first question you have 2650. So how will you write your answer? 2650 you have. Now how will you write? The given number h divisible by 2, because ones digit of the given number h 0. So what you can write, the given number 2650 is divisible by 2 because ones digit of the given number is 0. This should be your answer. Suppose in place of 0, if some other number you would be having, suppose some other question you have 2653, then how will you write your answer? You will write the given number 2653 is not divisible by 2 because the ones digit of the given number is 3. So in this way answer should be written. If suppose that is divisible, in this way you will write. If that will not be divisible, in this way answer should be written. And this is not only for divisibility test for 2, for others also. Suppose for 3 if you want to check, then for 3 also in the same manner answer should be written. So next we will see, here you have test the divisibility of the following numbers by 3. So, if you remember, for 3, what criteria was there? Suppose first number you have 7, 3, 3. What we need to do, this is required to be added, 7 plus 3 plus 3, and find the sum of these numbers. So, 7 plus 3 is equal to 10 and 10 plus 3 is equal to 13. Now, this number is required to be seen that is divisible by 3 or not. If this number is divisible by 3, then the given number will be divisible by 3, otherwise not. So, you have 13, obviously 13 is not divisible by 3, and that is why the given number 733 will not be divisible by 3. In this way, answer should be written. So, how will you write answer? You see once, your given number is 733. Now, you have to check this number is divisible by 3 or not. What we will do? If we add the digits of 733, we get what we will get? 7 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 13. Since you will write, since 13 is not divisible by 3, and therefore the given number 733 will not be divisible by 3. In this way, answer should be written. If we add the digits of 733, we get 7 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 13. Since 13 is not divisible by 3, and therefore the given number 733 will not be divisible by 3. Suppose in place of 733 some other number will be there, and the sum what you are getting that will be divisible by 3, then it is needed to be written. The same thing, if we add the digits of this, we will get this, since what sum you will get will be is divisible by 3, and that is why this number will be divisible by 3. In that way you need to write answer. You can see one example. Suppose you have 735. In this case, what you will write? You will write, if we add the digits of 735, we get what you will get? 7 plus 3 plus 5 is equal to 15. You will write, since 15 is divisible by 3, therefore the given number 735 is divisible by 3. In this way, answer should be written. Next, you see question number 3, test the divisibility of the following numbers by 4. If you remember what was told, the number formed by the ones and tens digit, you see, suppose in this given number you have 6, 3, 7, 1, 2, here ones and tens digit you have 12. This is required to be seen, this number is divisible by 4 or not. If this number is divisible by 4, the given number will be divisible by 4. So, obviously, 12 is divisible by 4, that is why the given number will be divisible by 4. So, how will you write answer? By seeing ones and tens digit, the number formed 12 is divisible by 4, That's why the given number 63712 will be divisible by 4. In this way, answer should be written. Next, you see, next question, you have test the divisibility of the following numbers 5. I hope you will be able to write your answer. As I told, divisibility of 5, you see, if you remember, once digit must be 0 or 5. Here you check, first number you have 4, 9, 6, 5. If once digit is 5, then the given number will be divisible by 5. Second number you see, 2, 3, 5, 9, 0. Here you see, once digit you have 0. Here third, 3, 5, 2, 0, 8. The once digit you have 8. So, obviously, it will not be divisible by 5. So, for divisibility test of 5, what you need to remember, once digit must be 0 or 5. If it is not there, that the given number will not be divisible by 5. Next, you see, test the divisibility of the following numbers by 6. If you remember, what was told? The given number, suppose here you have 7, 1, 2, 3, 2. It is required to be seen, the given number must be divisible by 2 and 3. If the given number is divisible by 2, you check that, because once digit is 2, so definitely the given number will be divisible by 2. Now you check the divisibility test of 3, you add this number 7 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2. What you will get? 7 plus 1 8, 8 plus 2 10, 10 plus 3 13 and plus 2 15. So, obviously, this 15 is also divisible by 3, and that is why the given number 71232 will be divisible by 3. Now, we found the given number 71232 is divisible by 2 as well as by 3, and that is why the given number 71232 will be also divisible by 6. So, the answer should be written in this way. 71232 you have, this number you have. So, what we need to do, how will you write answer? If the given number 71232 is divisible by 2 and 3, then this will be also divisible by 6. So, now we will check. Now, we will see divisibility test of 2. Since once digit is 2, therefore, the given number Seven, 1, 2, 3, 2 will be divisible by 2, and if we add 7 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2, we get 15. The sum 15 is divisible by 3, therefore the given number is also divisible by 3, and hence the given number seven 1 2 3 2 will be divisible by 6. So in this way answer should be written. If the given number 7 1 2 3 2 is divisible by 2 and 3, then this will be also divisible by 6. Now we will see divisibility test of 2. Since once digit is 2, therefore the given number 7 1 2 3 2 will be divisible by 2, and if we add, suppose if you are adding this number you get 15, the sum 15 is divisible by 3, therefore the given number is also divisible by 3, and hence the given number 7 1 2 3 2 will be divisible by 6. In this way answer should be written. Next we will see divisibility of the following numbers by 7. So if you remember what was there for divisibility test of 7, once digit you see, suppose you have 117, once digit you have 7, make double of this, 7 into 2 will be 14. Now you find the difference of this number and the remaining number. Here you have 14 minus 11, what you will get? 3. So if this difference is coming either 0 or multiple of 7, then only that the given number will be divisible by 7, otherwise not. So here in this case you have difference 3, and that is why this number will not be divisible by 7. In the same way other questions also can be seen and can be checked. Next you have test the divisibility of the following numbers by 8. So as we had done for 4, number formed by ones and tens digit we see in divisibility test of 4, and for divisibility test for 8 what we see? Ones, tens and hundreds place. Number formed by ones, tens and hundreds place, if this number is divisible by 8, then the given number will be divisible by 8. So just you need to check, you have number formed 792. So you check this number is divisible by 8 or not. If this will be divisible by 8, then this the given number 36792 will be divisible by 8, otherwise not. In the same way other questions are there, you need to find out. Next you have divisibility test for 9. So here you see what you need to remember, the same formula is applied what we have for 3. The numbers are required to be added. Suppose you have 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 in this question, then what you will get? 12. Now you see, after adding the number, what sum you are getting? If that is divisible by 9, then that number will be divisible by 9, otherwise not. So here you see you are getting 12, this number is not divisible by 9, and that is why the given number will not be divisible by 9. The other numbers also can be checked, you add that number, if the sum what you are getting, that sum if that is divisible by 9, then the given number will be divisible by 9. Next you have divisibility of the following numbers by 10 you need to see. So very simple thing is there, if once digit is 0, that number will be divisible by 10, otherwise not. This is so easy. So here you see you have once digit 0, only one number you have, 5790, and here you have 5, so this will not be divisible, this is 5, again this will not be divisible. Next, you have test the divisibility of the following numbers by 11. So, if you remember what was told, if you remember, it was told that if the in the given number, suppose you have 6, 6, 3, 1, 1, in this number you need to find out the difference of the sum of the numbers which are in odd places and even places. So, here you have in odd places you have 6 plus 3 plus 1, it means 10. Now, in even places you have 6 plus 1 and that is equal to 7. Find the difference. If difference you are finding, you will get 3. So, after getting this difference, if the difference is coming 0 or multiple of 11, then that number will be divisible by 11, otherwise not. So, I hope you remember this. So, in the same way, you add the numbers which are in odd places and even places, and then you find the difference, and then you need to check that should be either 0 or multiple of 11, then only that number will be divisible by 11. Okay, next we will see, in each of the following replace by the smallest number to make it divisible by 9. So, for this question you need to know what is the divisibility test for 9. Suppose you take this number 2, then asterisk you have star 1, 3, 5. What is the divisibility test for 9? The numbers are required to be added and we need to see that number is divisible by 9 or not. So, here what we need to do, 2 plus star plus 1 plus 3 plus 5. You add this number, what you will get? 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, 3 and 3, 6, 6 and 5, 11. So, 11 plus star. So, what number should be added on this, so that what sum you will get, that will be divisible by 9, we need to see. So, 9 1 is 9, 9 2 is 18. So, 18 should come. If 18 will come, definitely this number will be divisible by 9. So, in this place, what number is required? 11 plus 7. So, that you will get sum 18, and if sum, if you are getting multiple of 9, then the given number will be divisible by 9. So, here in place of star, 7 should be replaced. So, in this way you need to find out all the numbers, you check that, and only one thing you need to remember, the divisibility test for the given number you must know, so that easily you can find out. So, I hope in this way you will be able to solve the rest of the questions. Here you see, which of the following are prime numbers? So, easy it is, already you have learned what are prime numbers. Prime numbers are the numbers which are having only two factors, 1 and itself, and you have seen the method also, how to find out prime and composite number from 1 to 100. Find out you know the how to find out the prime numbers in between 1 to 200 and 1 to 400. So, see those things and then you try to solve all the questions. I hope you will be able to solve question. Next day we will start prime factorization. So, it will be better once yourself you go through properly this prime factorization, and then we will start exercise. So, till then, thank you. Thank you.